My wall's gonna hate me by the time we're done with this adventure. It's not that common to get that many bolts during a playthrough, but trust me, I found a way. Greetings all, it's Blue Knight. Welcome back to Ratchet & Clank. Previously, we dealt with Quark on the Gemlik base and found ourselves to planet Atlantis. We also met up with a fellow named Steve who looked very similar to Quark, I don't know why. But we got, I can find it in the gadget section, the Gadgetron PDA. This is pretty much a portable Gadgetron vendor. So whenever you have it selected, hit circle, the vendor will pull up right away. So no more have to rely on stationary vendors themselves in order to get ammo or get any new weapons. You can now do it portable from now on. Today, we're going to continue on planet Atlantis because we still got a heck of a lot more to do. To start, we're going to activate the real Gadgetron vendor. Because it's not going to be very common for us to use this now that we have the PDA. We can now buy the Tesla Claw. This thing is going to be very advantageous to us during our time here on Atlantis. Set down this platform first. You know, actually, I'm going to have to change my weapon set now that I have the Tesla Claw before I explain this new weapon any further. So give me a minute, please. Not much change. All I did was make room for the Tesla Claw and bring out our blaster. I also want to give more time to the drone device and the decoy glove because, like I stated before, I don't use them that much in regular playthroughs, but I'm going to try to give them as much screen time as possibly can. So, the Tesla Claw works kind of like the Paraster. You have to hold down the circle button to activate its use, but unlike the Paraster, it can actually attack enemies whether they're on your level or when they're in the air. Originally, this was going to have a different use. The Tesla Claw was meant to grab enemies and then throw them, and the arc would be kind of different that way. But it ended up getting changed later on in development. I guess it was just too OP for the player to use. At least that's what the developers thought. But the Tesla Claw is still a very fantastic weapon in its current state. I think this is one of my top three, well, this fits in my top three favorite weapons in this game. It's that useful. It can take down some pretty tough enemies, but it's not useful against everything. Let's see, I think I'll use the Devastator on this mini bomber. Very good. Wow, three rock is just as much as the Blark Space Fighter. I was not expecting that. Hence why I once again would prioritize using the Visa Bomb gun over the Devastator, because that can take out anything in one blow. I'll bring up my Tesla Claw again against these Scout Bots. Oh, more of you Electroids. They're also called Plasma Bots, but I'll stick with Electroids because they're kind of like the upgrade to what we encountered back at Velden, back in the beginning of the game. So you could use a Tesla Claw to eliminate them, but if that doesn't work, I highly recommend using the Agent of Doom. Because they can sneak under the Electroid's arc, they'll be able to attack them no problem. So if you're having trouble using any other weapon, I highly suggest using the Agent of Doom. This is pretty much the level that made me respect the Agent of Doom a lot more now than I did when I was a lot younger. If I only realized that how useful these guys would be against those freaking Electroids, then that would save me a lot of stress from past playthroughs. While those Electroids are getting taken out by those Agents of Doom, oh, I thought this would actually use as a cover. I guess that didn't work. So the reason why I have this many bolts is that I was originally going to use those to get the Ultra Nanotech, but I came to the realization that we just got that, got the premium nanotech, so I'm going to stick with the 5 nanotech spears for a little longer before we upgrade down the line, but I will do that by game's end, or at least somewhere near game's end. Besides, I want to give myself a bit of a challenge when it comes to Atlantis, as if this level isn't challenging enough for me already. I just kind of felt like getting that Ultra Nanotech upgrade would help me out a lot more, which would be the smart thing to do. But I think that would bring me a lot less stress, and the potential for failures and for entertainment value would probably go down the tubes. Oh boy, oh no, not the Visibomb, not the Visibomb! Get the Agents of Doom quickly. Get down to one Nanotech Sphere. Ah, damn it, didn't get out time. I was so caught up in my ramblings that I didn't realize I had the Visibomb gun out. I thought I had the Aegis of Doom equipped. So that was just my own fault at that particular moment. Okay, this time I'm going in with the drone device, but unfortunately, I had to use the rest of my Aegis of Doom along the way. So I'm gonna substitute with the Tesla Claw for now. I could use the PDA, but I still wanted to see if I could take these guys out before I had to rely on such a method. And those drone devices work in space, well, for the most part. I just took a hit as soon as I said that. But they managed to protect me from 3 of the 4 electroids. That's pretty good. I was contemplating on using the decoy glove for a split second, but I think that would just hinder me more because they will still sweep across the landscape. So that's why I opted not to do that. Take the swing shot and go to his first target. There's an easy gold bolt right there. However, this is one of the gold bolts that always tricked me when I was younger, mostly because I didn't think I would have to look up in order to see a Versa target up there. So this is one of the gold bolts that I always missed out on many, many times. It's a Sonic Summoner or a Sandmouse house here, so why not? This would be a good time for the Sonic Summoner to come in handy. Besides, we don't have Clank with us, so this would be the closest thing we'll have to a companion for the time being. Drop down there. Bolts over there, yes there is. Every little bit helps, even though I have like 40,000 to my name right now. I'm gonna save that for the Ultra Nanotech, like I said, but that'll be down the line. Okay, I think there's a mini bomber over there. Whoa! That first bomb almost got me. I didn't think the range would be that far out. Well, I'd be that close to it. The real enemy I wanted to worry about is that electroid up there. I guess this would be the best case to get the Sandmouse out here. But it's gonna aim diagonally down. That Sandmouse is not gonna help at all. Tesla Claw worked just the same. I think it's preoccupied with some other scout bots off screen. Yeah, right over there. Freaking Sandmouse. I wanted him to go after the electroid, but he got distracted. Oh well, it still worked out in the end. I still have 3 spheres to my name for the time being. There's a machine gun turret over there. Just use the Tesla Claw or the Sandmouse could take him out for me, whichever way works. Okay, so there's a electroid hatch over here, but they're not gonna come out quite yet. Not until you go up on the grind rail. And their Sandmouse friend disappears, so I'm gonna handle these guys by myself. I'll handle as if trying to be a coward and get away from them. Because this will pretty much just act as an obstacle for this grind rail segment. Just pay attention to which electroid is firing off their electric arc, I guess. And then pay attention to how to avoid the attacks. Yeah, I'm supposed to go to the right. Kind of a bit close there, but I figured I would make it. Or actually at the end.
Hey, welcome to my shop! What can I get you?
I'm looking for Drek.
Sure, yeah, I got lots of stuff on sale. After the bombing, no one is around to buy anything.
Are you okay?
Low prices? Oh, you bet. I can make you a deal on a busted turburetor, a mangled carbonizer, or I got this info bot.
Guess that bombing was pretty loud, huh?
Oh, you're one shrewd negotiator. I'll tell you what. I can let this infobot go for half price. Well, that's about it for me.
Thanks.
Quit your complaining. I gave you a great deal. Sheesh!
Afraid to go out at night? Afraid to go out during the day? Just plain afraid? Then you need this! The Ultra Mech Unlimited. This mech is the ultimate in personal defense system. Blarg Industries is now taking pre-orders. Get yours before it's too late.
Now that's what I call serious firepower. Clank's gonna be jealous if he sees this.
We finally get gate coordinates to planet Core 2. I think it's how it's pronounced. Core 2. Core 2. I'm pretty sure it's Core 2. I'm just overcomplicating it a bit. So now we're done with this path. With this switch. And this will bring us back down to the hub area. Okay, I thought this one of the paths we unlocked right now, but I guess that's gonna have to wait till later. In the meantime, we can actually get a skill point right now. We'll have to take out three of those Blarky ships off of the distance with a Visibob gun. You can't aim with a Devastator, I don't think you're close enough to do so. So the Visibomb gun is the only weapon we'll have to use in this case. That's provided I can find one of the enemy ships, because none of them are spawning in right now, that's weird. I saw like two of them pass by before I was gonna begin to record. But now they're not showing up, how typical. Okay, I see one over there. Will I be able to make it in time? Is my range gonna be just... No, it's not. I thought I would be close enough to get to that blocking ship, but that wasn't the case. That one, however, is a different story. Like with some of these skill points we've dealt with in the past, you can just pick out one ship and then pretty much spam going after that path over and over again until you get the skill point. I see one over there. I think that's the one we actually went after just a few moments ago. Got it. Two down, one to go. See, where's the last one? It's gonna come over here. I want to deal with any of those enemies right now, provided I get hit by that turret first. Got it. That was actually a lot shorter than I thought it would be. That usually takes me quite a bit of time to do. Alright, this path. Ooh boy, this path. I remember giving me a hell of a time on many past runs of this game. Even when I was going through my whole Ratchet and Clank kick last year, this still gave me a lot of trouble. First you gotta deal with is those Blark Heavy Interceptors. They're pretty much your security guards for this path. If you get alerted, if they get alerted, then you'll have to deal with all the turrets that are in that immediate vicinity. So you'll have to keep a huge eye on those guys. I advise taking them out first because, of course, if you do so, you won't have to deal with any more of those turrets at all. It could be very simple if you deal with one of them at first, but dealing with a pack, that's pretty difficult to do. So I advise going after those heavy interceptors very heavily. Well, part of the pun, of course. A lot of scout bots to deal with just now. Gives me a lot of bulls, so I'm not gonna complain. Now, this is where I thought of saying that using the sniper, not the sniper, the blaster as a sniping weapon. It is very useful in this particular path. You can take out a lot of those turrets and those scout bots before you even have a chance to step forward. Of course, go L1 in first person mode to activate that sniping feature of the blaster. It's a pretty ironic thing to say. But you'll be right as rain if you're able to do that. I saw a heavy interceptor up there. I'll use my Visibob gun because that'll just take him out one blow. I think I'll take out another one with a Visibob before I go up that ladder. That's not gonna work. So as you've seen that, if you do attack a heavy interceptor, that will either go crazy or all the other ones in the vicinity will go crazy because you obviously made them take damage. Gotta be careful here, there's a lot of turrets that'll crisscross. Deal the hell on that, no problem though, that's good. I'll use the Devastator to go after those heavy interceptors. Kind of rely on the Visibomb a bit too much as of late, but I want to showcase it. That'll be the perfect time to use those Devastators against the heavy interceptors. Yeah, saw one off of the distance, but I'll get all those bulls first. I know I'm already swimming in bulls, but it's never a bad thing to have a few extra on hand. Besides, all of that could go to that Ultra Nanotech, so kinda wanna get as many as I can before I even think about going back to Orxon. So this always tricks me. There's a couple of turrets at the end of this road that always surprise me, no matter how many times I go through this level. I don't know why, it's just that after dealing with all the other enemies, I think I'm safe, but then those turrets just surprise me and I'm always reminded that they exist. able to get to that first target very fast. Usually I have to rotate around that ship at least once before I'm able to get to this particular segment. There's a bunch of versatile targets up there. Now, you could avoid them because there's a bunch of turrets in this particular room. Actually, I use my agents. Because I want to take them out and get all the bolts they have. Actually, I'll use my Visibomb gun. There could be a chance I can take out two at a time. And that's why this room is extremely dangerous. Look at all those turrets we have to deal with. I'll use my blaster to take out most of them, though. Gotta be careful, only down the one nanotech sphere. Ooh, that was close. Oh, that was even closer. My blaster's not close enough to get them. Okay, if I can stay this far back. Go after one. I think it's one out. Whoa! Oof. Yeah, a bit too close again. I'm trying to find the other turret. I can use my Visibomb, but like I said, I feel like they're relying on that a bit too much as of late. Those ones are right near the door that I'm sitting right now. So I'll take them out with a Devastator. Oh, that actually took them all out. Cool. Okay, I'll slide over to the side a bit. I should take out both of these turrets with a blaster. Very nice. I'm able to get all these bolts now. Hopefully I won't die. I have to reset going back to this, to the beginning of this path. Okay, that was weird. I don't need to go on the PlayStation Network in order to run this game, so that was a kind of a weird time for that to pop up. At least with the nanotech sphere here. Okay, there's another turret at the end of this platforming segment. I use the Devastator to take that out. We should be nearing the end of this path too. I'm not sure which one I always consider to be the most dangerous because both of these paths that we've been on today, they always give me a lot of trouble. So it's kind of hard to say which one I despise more. Well, no! I hate it when that happens. I hate it when that happens so much. I don't know why. But that particular scenario has happened to me more than once. For some reason, the sweet shot just doesn't work very well when you're trying to transport from one movie platform to another. And it really bugs me. That means gotta go all the way back. And we're right at the end of that path too. Oh, that sucks so much. As much as I want to get those bolts from those enemies, I'm just gonna leave him be. I already spent too much time on this level as it is. So I'm just gonna proceed on through to the remainder of this path and try to finish this as soon as possible, provided that I don't have any more swing shot shenanigans happen again. And I gotta wait for another rotation of this to happen. So you may be wondering why I'm not, I don't have the PDA out on my weapon wheel. Well, that's because that particular item actually takes up a weapon slot, hence why it's in the gadget section of the menu. And I kind of don't like doing that because I'd rather just use the weapon wheel for weapons and gadgets that are more useful. It's nothing more than just a portable gadget farm vendor, which is useful in itself, but I feel like that would be more contributed to having better weapons or better gadgets in the weapon wheel than just have a PDA in that slot, or at least in one of the slots. So that's my reasoning why I don't have the PDA out. I'm not saying it's not useful, it's just that I feel like I could use the weapon wheel itself for more better weapons and gadgets. Speaking of useless gadgets, it's time we bring out the metal detector once again, which can also be used as a slot in the weapon wheel, which is of course something I don't do because it's very situational. Even then, you don't get that many bolts out of it, probably like a few hundred at best, but a few hundred is nothing compared to some of the stuff you want to get in this game, as we've seen. At least we're at the end of this path. I can't believe I died so close to it too, I'm still really bitter about that. At least we finally found the morph array. Hold down circle and keep the beam focused on an enemy. When the meter's full, that enemy will transform. This is nothing more than a joke weapon at best, but I guess it can be useful. The thing is that depending on the size of the enemy themselves, will determine how much time it will take for the morph array to take effect. I'll show that off sometime soon in the future, but not right now, because I don't think this last path we can take will have any enemies on the counter. I could be wrong. Usually this will be where I would end the part, but I'm actually going to take my time going across this particular segment. Now, if I remember correctly, there's also another skill point I want to get to as well. It involves taking out all these searchlights, believe it or not. I'm not sure if you have to go through the entire Swingshot course we just unlocked to get this skill point, or just take out all of the searchlights that you see in your wake. But I'm gonna take them all out just in case. At least take out all the ones that I see. There might be a couple on that path we just took to get the morph array too. Those might count towards this skill point, as well as all these ones surrounding our landing pad. I'm gonna take those out too, because it never hurts to be too cautious when you go after the skill point. And I don't want to stop to look at my notes right now to see if I'm right or wrong, so I'm just gonna take them all out and just be none the wiser about it, I suppose. Take this taxi to go back up here. That's where the Swingshot path is going to end up. And you saw for a split second, but there's a gold bolt at the end of this path as well. So you know our incentive for going through this route. But you have to unlock it after completing both of the previous routes we've taken on Atlantis. I'm not sure why that works for some reason, but that's how it operates. You have to go through both paths on Atlantis before you're able to access that switch that was blown up from one of the blocking ships. And this makeshift staircase is going to be our starting point to getting through this. So far so good. Nothing out of the ordinary when it comes to using the Swingshot. But it will get a bit tougher over time, so don't let your guard down too much because of that. Do these count towards a skill point? No, they don't. So from this point on, there's going to be movable versus targets, I suppose. Mobile, that's the word I'm looking for. Mobile versus targets. I think we just saw one for a couple of seconds. Am I actually facing the right way? No, I'm not. I was facing the wrong way. That explains so much. So here goes that robot. Actually, I think that's a heavy interceptor as well. It looks like it. I think it is. It just does have the searchlight. That's what makes it so different. So you have to worry about those mobile Versa targets as well as all these stationary yellow ones, but also keep your eye on these searchlights if you're going for 100% this game. Which of course, being the completionist that I am gonna do that. I'll just wait for the next heavy interceptor to come along. This one's gonna be a bit risky to time. So you might want to take a couple swings and wait to see how far the interceptor will go out. You might have to latch on to those mobile versus targets a few times to get to these yellow ones, but it should work out just the same if you're quick enough. I want to try to adjust my swing over to this next one. I'll wait for the next heavy interceptor to come by because I think I was a bit too late on that. And I see the versus target at the end. Not the versus target, the gold bolt. There's a versus target. Well, actually, there was another versus target there, and I was almost near death for a second. I was about to fall down. That saved me. Whew. That was actually a smooth run compared to some of the previous runs I've had going through this route, to be honest. A couple of touch and go moments, but nothing out of the ordinary. And wait, didn't I not get... I think I may have missed one. I think I may have missed a streetlight somewhere. Okay, this is worrying now. could have sworn I got them all. Then again, this is one of the skill points that I've read up that can be a bit wonky to get. Sometimes it will work, sometimes it won't. I think I'm just gonna die and have everything reset so I can just go through it all over again. That's probably gonna be the game plan I'll take. There's a skill point. Now that's what I wanted to see. I think there might be a few I missed out. Probably a couple on the landing pad. Or at least at the platform near the landing pad. And probably a couple at the upper city portion of this entire level. That might have been the reason why I didn't get that skill point to start. But at least we got everything taken care of. At least I think so. I can't check the amount of gold bolts we have here. But I know for a fact we got all the mission stuff taken care of. So next time on Ratchet & Clank, we're gonna go to Court 2 and see if we can do anything there regarding those robots we saw. I think those were called the Ultramechs. Until we meet again, farewell for now.